Never put deodorant on just before you're going to film a video because it will make you sneeze.
Hi and welcome back to my channel. Now before I get started on the video, I want to address three things. One, yes, I have changed the colour of my hair. But yeah, I said in my last video that I wanted to go lighter, sort of blondy. And so a few weeks ago, I bleached it in preparation for dyeing it. And then our shower broke, so I was left with this patchy yellow, orange, black hair, which looked horrific. As my niece pointed out, I looked like a giraffe. So this is the colour that it is at the moment. I want a little bit more blonde through it, but I'm going to give it a break because it's had two bleaches and a dye on it. So that's a bit too much peroxide for my liking. Second thing I want to address, my room is a mess. It has also changed around a little bit, I think. Yeah, I don't think I've filmed a video in this setup. But it's a complete mess because I'm going away for the weekend and I'm in the middle of packing and I needed to refilm this video. Refilm because I did film it, but I looked like a twat. So here I am. And the third thing I wanted to address. And the third thing I wanted to address, in case you didn't hear what I just said, I am going away for the weekend. I am going away in my car. Yes, I have had my car for just over a week now, and I picked it up a hell of a lot quicker and easier than I thought I would. The second day I had it, I drove to Buckingham, and then 3 days after I have it, I drove to Milton Keynes, and now I'm kind of okay with driving it. It's hard. Gonna say that it is, especially left turns, because you're having to hold it at a very strange angle whilst accelerating or braking. So I'm not very keen on left turns. I've curbed it a few times but no damage yet, which is a first because all the other cars that I've driven I've crashed within the first few weeks of getting in them. But yeah, it's going really well and I am making a vlog on the whole kind of getting a car and learning to drive it experience. So yeah, you can look forward to that. This video is going to be about something that I don't think I've talked a great deal about on my channel, and that is anxiety or anxiety and panic attacks. I think I've talked about it more on my blog, and I'll leave a link below to my blog in case you haven't read it. So head over there and subscribe. I'm a bit lax at uploading at the moment. Life is in the way and I'm trying to put a lot of effort into building up my YouTube channel. And it's hard thinking of things to write about that don't kind of cross over with my videos. I want to try and get a balance between the both, but at the moment my focus is on my YouTube channel because I do have almost 40 blog posts over there, so go over there and check it out. Now, the video. As I said, I want to talk a bit about anxiety, in particular, obviously, because I have experience with it, my anxiety and what mine stems from, what triggers it, how I deal with it, and all of that. Now, it seems every week that a new celebrity is coming out as having anxiety, and whilst I don't doubt that some of these people may suffer from an anxiety disorder, there is a difference between having an anxiety disorder and being a bit nervous about something, like having a situation that makes you feel nervous or having butterflies. And there's also a difference between having anxiety and being a bit shy or introverted. These things aren't the same. You can be all of them. Having an anxiety disorder is not the same as being shy or introverted. And I think people have taken it upon themselves to self-diagnose a lot of the time. Again, I'm not saying that this is for everyone, but if you're coming out saying, oh, I'm a bit nervous about something, I don't want to do it, then that wouldn't go down too well. But if you're coming up with a genuine mental health problem, then people aren't really going to doubt that, are they? Because you can't really say you're faking it. Well, I've had a lot of people saying that to me in the past, but that's just because they... The first thing I wanted to address is the difference between an anxiety attack and a panic attack. And I have suffered from both, and I do suffer from both. An anxiety attack is often a reaction to a trigger or a situation. And the symptoms are the same as with a panic attack. So you can be, you know, mentally, you can be fearful, afraid, you can be nervous, apprehensive. Physically, it can affect you in pretty much every damn way you can think of. It can affect your breathing, your heart. You can be in pain, you can feel sick, you can be tired. Anxiety can really, really fuck with your body. And it's the same with panic attacks. Panic attacks don't tend to come on from a trigger. They tend to come on out of the blue. They're unprovoked, they're unpredictable, and they last for longer. If you suffer from anxiety attacks and you know what triggers them, then you can tend to avoid that trigger. And with panic attacks, because you don't know what is going to provoke them, then you might just avoid certain situations altogether because you don't know where it's coming. You can become quite reclusive and shut down, really. Now, as I said, I've suffered from both anxiety attacks and panic attacks, and whilst I've always known the difference between the two, it's hard to put into words what the difference between the two is, which is why I had it on my phone to tell you what the medical official differences are. I want to try and focus on the anxiety side of things, although I will do some crossovers. For me, with my anxiety, I can tend to be paranoid about situations, and my brain will look for evidence to support that paranoia, thus kind of getting into a cycle that is pretty hard to break out of. And that's not helped by the fact that in the past my brain has normally been right, but that's because the people that I've been surrounded by are absolute twats. There are certain triggers that I have that make me very anxious, and I do my best to avoid them, but obviously you can't always avoid them. And if I am faced with one of those triggers, then it's safe to say that I'll become an anxious mess. And for me, it's about getting out of that situation. And as I've spoken about in the past, being a passenger in the car is something that is very terrifying for me. And you can't really get out of that situation, so it tends to be really hard for me. I will struggle to breathe. The best way I can describe it is all my senses feel hyper aware. So sight, smell, taste, everything. My skin feels kind of on edge, and kind of, I can feel everything but 10 times more. I can hear everything but 10 times more. It's pretty shit. I don't know how else to describe it. It is pretty shit. And as I said, the only ways that I can deal with it are getting out of that situation, avoiding the situation. Obviously the car one is unique because you can't get out of this situation. The way I deal with it tends to be closing my eyes and putting my music on as loud as I can, and focusing on the music. So listening to the beat, listening to the words, and just focusing my brain completely on that. It doesn't take it all away, but it helps to an extent. In terms of my other types of anxiety, I know, pretty much know most of the triggers. Sometimes I don't. Music is a big one for me. Noise, blocking noise out. So I will either put my music on really loud. I have a fan that I have on all the time because, first of all, I suffer from tinnitus, and that helps with that. But second of all, noises in the house set me on edge and make me an anxious mess. So having the fan there as a steady constant that kind of drowns out a little bit of the noise, I find really helpful. Distraction, obviously that's an obvious one. Watching something is hard because I've never been able to kind of sit down and watch something easily. My brain is always looking for something else to do, or something else to be afraid of, or something wrong. So one good thing for me is editing, like editing my videos, writing sometimes, it depends what mood I'm in, creating, so music, writing songs, working on things that tend to involve my brain completely, whereas opposed to just watching something, it's just kind of visual and oral. Yeah, oral as in ears. Unless it's something that I'm completely engaged with and that I have to concentrate on, it's not gonna distract me completely. One of the major parts of my anxiety is that I have this impending sense of doom, like something bad is about to happen. And I don't just mean like little bad, I mean big bad, like, oh, the big bad from Buffy. I mean proper, awful, tear my world apart bad. And that's why when I'm looking for things, like the evidence to support it, to support this doom that's coming. With my panic attacks, they kind of tend to be about the impending sense of doom, or they can literally just come on from nothing. I can just be, I can have the physical side effects or the mental. The physical ones is with my breathing, it goes really fucked up. The mental side is just I start overthinking, like thinking a million miles an hour. There's not really anything I can do to stop it. My boyfriend is really good at helping me come out of that, but obviously he's not here all the time, so I have to deal with it myself. And again, anxiety can affect anyone. It can come on for no reason. That can be the only mental health problem that you suffer from, so not everyone has to suffer from depression to have anxiety, but more often than not there is a, is it comorbidity? There is another disorder present, or if you're lucky like me, then you have several of them. One of the other things that I've not touched on, that I don't think I've talked really much about on either my channel or my blog, is how the anxiety is linked to my OCD. Now, first of all, when you hear the words OCD, you think of clean, tidy, obsessive, yeah, obsessive, but you think of that side of things, and my OCD has never been about that, as you can tell by the state of my room. Mine is all about things feeling right. So if a part of my body doesn't feel right, then I have to move it until it does. Or like when I was younger, if I was walking along and my hand scratched against like a post or something, I had to scratch the other one until it felt the same, and I would be stood there for ages until they felt right. If you're walking and you stand on like a tile or something that's uneven, and then that foot feels uneven and you have to make the other one feel the same, it's fucking horrible. And I had something with my hands as well where I had to pull the skin back from my nails until they all felt right, and I would literally sit there all day doing that. That side of things, I've kind of got a handle on. It's only if I talk about them or think about them that it's kind of comes present in my brain, but I've got a handle on that side of things. Is what affects my anxiety is the intrusive thoughts. I have really, really nasty, intrusive thoughts about things that you really don't want to think about, and they come in the most inappropriate situations, or when you're happy, they can come in any time. Sometimes they're just random, but sometimes they're like flashbacks and things, and you can't get rid of them, and the more you try and get rid of them, the more anxious you get and the more worked up about it you get. And something that I was taught and that I've read about is that when you have these sort of thoughts, the best thing you can do is just go with them. If you try and fight back against it, they will fight back stronger. So the best thing to do is just say, I'm having this thought can't hurt me, I'm just going to ride it like the waves, and eventually it will die down. It may not die down straight away, but you have to let it be for it to come down, and eventually as that thought comes in each different time, it will come in less and less because you're not fighting it so hard. I don't know how it works, I don't know why it works, but that's how it works. So I thought I would talk a little bit about that. If you want me to do a video on my OCD and my experiences with it, then it's something that I don't mind talking about. I've suffered from it since I was about 7 or 8, and I remember what started it off, and if you're interested in that, then let me know and I'll make a video on it. If not, then I won't. That is the end of this video. I hope you found it helpful. Another thing that people can feel when they're having an anxiety attack or panic attack is that something is going to happen to them. Whether if you've got a headache and you think your brain's going to explode, you think your heart's going to explode, your body, if you're in pain, you feel that physical pain and you're worried that it's going to trigger something, that it's actually something going wrong, and the more you worry about it, the worse your anxiety gets. And that's really hard to deal with. So that's the end of this video. I hope you found it helpful. If you have any questions, leave them below. If you have any ideas for videos, then let me know. And that's that, and I will see you next time. Thank you. Bye.